this to him. And you playing Krishna, you have to come up with reasons to defend yourself on the spot. And you know what I'll do? I'll use some things I already know about you. You know, like for instance, if I'm talking to KP, I'll say, yeah, but you drink coke. You lie, you don't tell people. You're a great guy for hiding things. Krishna, you're always like that. You see what I mean? Krishna's character is also like that. So I'll add things.
Drunkard.
I'll add things that happen to him every day. You know, and they'll add it so the whole village knows. Suppose we're all from this village, right? If suppose we're all from this village and you're pretending to be Krishna and I'm pretending to be Arjuna, I can bring a lot of things into the story which is about you. Right? And that's how people enjoy the story. So you may not know many of these details, but you'll hear people laughing and clapping because they're doing this improvised. They know the Mahabharata by heart. They know it backwards. Like I can for instance challenge you on stage and say, oh, you say you're Duryodhana. Do you know the names of all your brothers? You have to stand on stage and recite 100 names of your brothers. It's very personal. It's super personal.
Okay, that can become
like an old person. No, but it's a war of wits. It's a war of how good you are.
Yeah.
At some point, if that performer is not able to do it, this performer will give you a cue to go. But everybody in the audience knows I'm better. Right? Everybody knows who's good here. I'll give you a cue and say, oh, you don't have to recite all the names of your brothers if I know that you're not able to remember. But the whole audience knows I won the round, right? And I'll make an excuse and send you away from stage and say, oh, someone is calling you, why don't you go off stage, right? But then everyone knows I'm better than you, right? So that's how stars are born, and that's how they know the Mahabharata. Do you know the name? Who knows the name of Ravana's wife?
There are 99 wives.
One favorite one is Mandodari.
Yeah. What's the name of Ravana's son? Did he have one or two?
Two.
Okay, you're sure?
Ravana's yes.
Indrajit and Kumkaran.
Indrajit and?
Kumkaran.
Yes.
Yeah, Indrajit and Kumkaran.
Yes, that's right. The guy who calls you
Kumkaran is his
brother. Yeah,
no, Vibhishana is his brother.
No, Kumkaran
is also a brother.
No, Kumkaran is his brother-in-law.
Prakash.
No,
brother.
No,
he's his brother.
No.
Yeah, Prasen. Prasen and Indrajit.
Prasen and Indrajit. And they tell stories. There are different versions of the Ramayana. Right? So now if you hear a version that Nugli tells you, she'll tell you that in Ramayana, Ravan's daughter is Sita.
What?
That's their version.
Ravan. You
know, Ravan's daughter. So suddenly, who's the villain here?
If Ravan's daughter
is Sita. Yeah, you see what I mean? Yeah, so the whole thing changes, right? Yeah, he is worshipped. He is considered God. So anyway, so what I'm trying to say is there's a whole lot of ways that you can understand the epics. Okay, everybody get up. We'll just do one small step in Yakshagana. Come, get up.
It's a fighting room.
But there we can't understand the language.
Yeah, that's true. But you can watch the dance. There'll be lots of dance. There'll be lots of dialogue. And they will be singing and it will be glorious. You can go into the green room and see them getting ready. Okay, you can do that. And they'll be wearing all sorts of costumes.
I have one question.
They wear about 7 to 8 kgs of costume when they perform.
What?
Yeah. And they perform the whole night. Okay, I have a question.
Can you
No, you're watching a public show. This is a show where a place where you can go and book in Saligram. Like in a particular temple. It is done as a, what do you call it, a harike. Do you know what a harike is? Like a
offering
to a particular deity that is booked. Okay, so everybody stand. Get up, guys. Okay, I want to see everybody's legs. Stand around me so I can see you. Come this side. Next to each other. This way. Okay, so let's do. I want you to do the pattern. I want you to do the tala beat. I want you to do the tala. No, just me. Wait. The tala beat in with your mouth and with your hand. Okay, so let's do the first one. Yo, boys. Okay. Okay, let's try with your legs. It's just three beats. Okay, so you will do, it's just three beats. Right? Do with your legs. Let me see three beats. 1, 2, 3. Okay, we'll now do with the, you got the legs?
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll do hands.
Yeah, Guinness World Record person.
So your hands. So what happens is, watch me. One round. Hold hands like this. Okay. Got it? Super. Okay. So now we won't move the hands. We'll just do the legs and then we'll move the hands. Okay? You gotta move your hips. Okay? God gave hips for us to move it like Shakira. Okay? So, okay. 1, 2, 3. Start. Very good. It just goes 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's make a run. Follow me. Come.
Go.
Alright. Okay, one big round of Takadimi Takita. Alright. Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3. Start.
Nice. It looks like you are doing wrestling.
Super. Stop. One time. Which story?